If you find that you're copy-pasting your Go test a lot, it might be time for a slightly different approach. Hi, my name is Wani Bryson. Today we're going to look at a common technique to change our test from looking like this to something a little bit more maintainable like this. First, we're going to write a simple test. Next, we're going to convert that test into a table-driven test. And finally, we're going to look at how we can easily add test cases to our table-driven test. Firstly, we're going to create a simple unit test. So I'm going to create a package here called tutorials/table-test. And now we're going to create a file called contains_test.go. And in here, we'll give it the package name table-test. And now we can define our test. So I'm going to go with test_contains, which of course takes an input of testing.t. And inside here, we're going to set result is equal to strings.contains, and the string to search will be it's dangerous to go alone, and then the substring to look for will be dangerous. Next, we want to check that result is true, and if it isn't, then we're going to call t.fatal with the message expected true. And then lastly, we can jump back into the terminal and call goTest, and it passes. Writing a test case this way is fine, but if we want to add additional test cases, like what happens when the substring isn't in our string, or what if there are multiple instances of that substring, we may end up copy-pasting this test. Copy-pasting ultimately makes our tests harder to maintain. An alternative approach is using table-driven testing. So now we're going to convert our test into a table-driven test. So I'm going to start by defining test cases, which is going to be a list of structs. The struct will contain a name, which will be a string, which will be an input string, a substring, which will also be our other input string, and finally expected, which is our expected Boolean result. Now we will define these test cases in here. So I'm going to start with the test case that we already have. I'm going to give it the name single because it has a single substring match in there. The string will be this line here. It's dangerous to go alone. So I'm just going to cut this out here and put it in here. And then the substring will be the string dangerous. Expected result is going to be true, and we need to add a comma there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to loop over all of our test cases with for test cases equal to the range of test cases. And then in here we're going to call t.run to run a subtest, and the name of this is going to be our test case name. And then the test function goes in here, and we're just going to copy paste this code up into t.run but change a few things. So strings.contains is now going to be looking for our test case input string, and the substring that it's looking for is going to be our test case.substring. We also aren't going to check that result is true anymore. We're going to check that the result is going to be equal to test case.expected. And inside this t.fatal, we're going to make this message a little bit more useful by saying expected value and add our test case expected value in here. So now we have a table-based test, and we can jump back into the terminal, and if we go test with the verbosity flag, we can see that we now have test contains, but it also calls out the subtest that we're executing. So adding more test cases is really easy. If we jump back into the code, we can copy-paste this test case, but this time change the name to none, and instead of it's dangerous to go alone, I'm going to change this to take this. And for the substring that we're going to look for, I'm going to change this to good luck. And the expected value will be false. And if we jump back into the terminal and run this again, now we see that both tests pass with the two different test case names. The great thing here is that if the contains interface changes in the future, we can keep these test cases more or less the same and just update the call to contains in the subtest. I hope that this technique keeps your test maintainable and easy to work with. I've been Wani Bryson, happy testing, and I'll see you later.